The team working on making Power BI easy to use for report creators is on a mission to make Power BI Desktop PowerPoint for data. We've taken many cues from Office to build familiar features. First, let's look at the new On-Canvas Watermarks feature, which helps to guide newer users in adding data to their reports, populating the Fields pane, and using drag and drop for visuals. Now you can simply upload from a SQL Server or Excel file or paste data directly into a blank table if you're copying from another tool. Pre-built data samples are available for users to experiment and get accustomed to what Power BI can do. For example, let's start with importing some data from Excel. You've got some data from our Power BI Ideas forum where users can provide suggestions to what we could add to Power BI. This will take us through the import wizard, and then we will load the data. This data will be pulled in, creating a connection back to the Excel spreadsheet and loading the appropriate fields into the field list on the right-hand side. There are now hints here as well to help with building visuals by simply dragging and dropping from the Fields pane onto the report canvas. Next, let's look at the Lasso Select feature, which allows users to conveniently select multiple data points within the Lasso boundaries for cross-filtering and highlighting. Manually selecting each of these data points can be quite tedious, particularly if you have very large charts. With the new Lasso feature, you can select an area of data points at once with various bar charts, or across a line chart, for instance, selecting the area with the highest sales. In a scatter chart, a common approach would be to isolate outliers that are clustered together, maybe products that aren't selling very well or that have low satisfaction. With this feature, everything else is filtered to just show the data points that have been selected. If you're using Power BI Desktop, simply hold down Control, then click and drag to create the lassoed area. If you're using the Power BI service, this feature is enabled by default. Lastly, we have the Small Multiples feature. This is one of the most asked for features on our Ideas forum and from enterprise customers, and it helps users split a visual into multiple versions of itself, presented side by side to ease comparisons between different data categories. For example, if we add a bar to this report, we can drag in the freight cost. Let's compare this by different countries. Here, our total freight costs have been split out into different areas. Now, we want to interpret the graph in more detail, for example, to view by product categories we sell. We can do this by adding additional categories to the legend. We can split this chart out further by adding a category into the Small Multiples field, which now breaks the chart out and provides small, repeated charts over each of the different categories of products being sold. From here, we can scroll through the various charts to access additional information, a helpful data visualization technique that brings extra power to Power BI reports. Previously, this would have required a manual effort to copy and paste multiple variations of the same visual to produce this effect, equaling extra time and effort to maintain the visuals. Additional formatting options will be coming in future releases as well. These latest Power BI enhancements will help users get the most out of their Power BI experience while boosting productivity.